Welcome back to 30 and 30, where I'm answering 30 of your real estate questions in 30 days so that you can be confident when you go out into the spring market. Okay, number 8 is coming from buyers, and buyers want to know, how do I get an edge in today's market? And that's such a good question. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to interview an agent to represent you. You don't want to just pick anybody. You want to make sure that this person's going to be aggressive. Ask them, you know, if they're not able to show you a house when it hits the market, do they have a team member, a colleague, a partner, somebody who could jump in and show you so that you don't miss out on it? And you just make sure that you have a good rapport and that you feel that your agent is going to be aggressive for you, because some agents don't want to work with buyers, truthfully. They prefer to work with sellers. So you want to just make sure you ask a bunch of questions. All right, I'm going to give you a bunch of tips and just little things that you and your agent can do that will make a big difference. It's a game of inches right now. So, okay, first off, you want to make sure that you get your pre-approval in place. So I don't care how good your credit is, income, and all of that, and you could be pre-approved like that, get it ready now so that when you see a house you love, you don't have to backtrack and get that pre-approval in place, because the offer will not be considered without it. Verification of funds as well. Just make sure you have that set aside if you're paying cash. All right, next, you want to make sure that you are set up on an MLS search so that every time something new hits the market, you get notified. Have your agent do that, because that's the most up-to-date information as opposed to Zillow and Realtor.com. This is real-time data. As things hit the market, you're going to get notified. Next, you want to make sure your agent calls that listing agent before you even take a look at the property, because you want to know, are there any offers on the table? Are there any coming in? Is there a timeline for looking at offers? If you see it tomorrow, will they wait till tomorrow? And chances are they will, but you know what? You don't know, because so if they get a juicy offer today, the seller just may go ahead and accept it. So find out what the details are, if there's a timeline for reviewing and so forth. Next, you want to make sure that your agent asks questions like, what is the seller's ideal timing? What is there a title company that they prefer to use? Are there any things that are excluded that the seller wants to take with them? Basically, what you want is to find out what the seller's wish list is, so that when you bring them that offer, it has a pretty little bow on it and all they want to do is just sign. So find out as much as you can prior to. You can also use an escalation clause where you don't have to come in at your max, but maybe you come in at a good price, willing to pay X amount of dollars above any other offer, not to exceed your max. And you also want to make sure that the listing agent is open to looking at those, because some listing agents want nothing to do with them. And then just make sure that your agent doesn't just send the offer and expect that it's going to get looked at and reviewed. Make sure, you know, if this seems like a very simple thing that should be done, but I'm always amazed when I just get an offer in my inbox with no call from the agent whatsoever and I had no idea it was coming. It's like a surprise offer. And it shocks me, because how do they not know that I wasn't negotiating something currently and my seller was literally signing another contract and they could have lost that property for their client? So make sure your agent stays in constant communication with the listing agent and be friends with the listing agent. You guys are on the same team. You want your agent to be the agent that the listing agent wants to work with. Sorry, if that makes sense. All right, well, those are my tips and tricks for working with or for getting an edge in today's market. If you have any other questions, put them in the comments or send me a message. And I hope you have a good rest of the day.